Very good. What is the opening? Pom, pom, pom. What is happening there?
It's like a port,
door?
Who's opening?
A door is opening. Very good. Yeah. Very good. The door is opening. On what?
Koninklijk, het is meer.
From the majesty, the king.
I think you're thinking it's opening up to a ballroom with a. Is that what you think?
Well, I don't know very.
When you start something like that, let your head imagine. Tum, pa pa pam 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 has a certain grace to it, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Almost like a dance, maybe?
Yeah.
Yeah? And maybe the door is opening into a ballroom where people are dancing? Yes? So it's smiling, yes?
Yes.
It's not It's ha, ha, ha. Not who, ha. So now begin it as if you're opening a door and you're happy with what you're seeing. Now play, just enjoy. Try. In the final analysis, you cannot really decide how did a Mozart or a Bach or a Beethoven or a Schubert decide to do that there and then and nothing else. That is the magic, the wonderment of music. And that's what music is all about. It's not just sounds and audiences and playing. It's to be part of the unexplainable beauty of human intelligence when it perceives and feels something.
Now solo.
You're going back to the tooting, yes? Okay. You see how many things you can think about when you're practicing something like this?
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's wonderful you have talent and you're musical. Think of what a wonderful adventure you're now going to begin in playing music. It's all these things to learn, to enjoy, to feel that you're doing it, not what someone else tells you. You yourself are doing it. That's when you really begin to enjoy being your own person, being you. You're talking, not somebody else. You're saying that. So look at the music. Sing it. Look at what it says. Try and read what happened during that time. Schubert's life, Bach's life, other things. Listen to the music that other people, not violin. Listen to Schubert's songs.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to Bach Brandenburg Concerti or Bach cantatas to get an idea from where did this man come. Most of all, enjoy yourself. Be happy. And let me hear, sometime when I hear you play again, let me hear, not that you're playing for me, let me hear, listen, I want you to hear what I'm playing. You make me listen. Understand?
Yes.
Good. It's been a pleasure. That's what we don't need anymore.
Oh.
That's wonderful. You're a darling, you know, and good luck. Just be good, okay? Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you for this lesson.
Okay. Why these two notes? Why not two others? Why in that direction? Why did I write Allegro or Andante? What does that mean? It is an idea. And I, the composer, want you, the performer, to understand what's in my heart in ways that I cannot explain to you. but the closer you try to understand, the better you will be able to tell the people listening to you. That's what music is all about.
Okay, ready.
You see, this way, this way, we got to go. Once more. All right?
Okay, I'm ready.
That's it.
Okay.
Makes it easy that way.
Nice to see you.
A herring,
yes.
Wat voor pianist ik word, of ik pianist word, ja, dat is voor mij wel, dat wil ik heel graag. Maar ik wil graag ook dirigent worden, maler, symfonieën, dirigeren. Het lijkt me wel erg mooi, maar ja.
Oh, thank you.
Maar het lijkt me natuurlijk wel onwijs gaaf om in de Carnegie Hall te spelen of zo. Maar ja, noem je natuurlijk ook even een zaal. Dat is natuurlijk de kick van iedereen. Die graag optreedt in een hele grote zaal te spelen. Want dat is extra spannend.
You always have the same feeling. Like in New York, when you walk to Carnegie Hall, is you walk here to the Concertgebouw. There are very, very few halls with that kind of tradition.
De kinderen van mijn leeftijd, als je internationaal bekijkt, dan zitten erg hoog niveau. En dan moet je veel voor studeren om zo'n hoog niveau te bereiken.
About Christian, let me handle it not good if he does not fulfill it, if I'm disappointed, yes? It's better that I will be astonished. What a gifted boy. How marvelous. Yes? Because the repertoire is not big. For a boy of 13, I played many more difficult pieces than Chopin. But if he plays it marvelously well, it will be a joy. Do?
I'm fine.
Very nice to see you. Actually, I'm glad you are going to play for me. I'm looking forward to hear you.
Thank you.
You look so elegant.
Thank you.
Now, I think we should open the piano. We should have somebody opening the piano for us. Yeah. I'll put this. That's it. Thank you. You see what a strong woman can do? All right. Now, you have the music of the composition that you're playing, the Chopin, yes? So why don't you let me listen and see what you're doing? That was very nice.
Thank you.
How did you think you played?
I think I played it better.
Some other
before. Times. Yes.
And what was better at that time?
Now I didn't play all the notes very
as clean. Yeah, that is true. And that, of course, is obvious. Everybody can hear that. But that is also not as important as certain other things. For instance, let's start from the beginning. And what I would like from you, when you do these, don't play like that. Finger it so that you have a feeling that you connect them. This connection is the beginning. So what I want you to do is that you take five, go to the second finger, and come down. So let me do that. You see, no, I don't. As you can see, Chopin has one pedal.
Oh, yeah.
So take that pedal and come down more natural, so that you make an opening for your theme, mm-hmm. Yes? Don't get slow. It's a preparation. That's not a preparation, yes? The preparation has to lead you to how the theme is going to be played. Your thumb, not.
Yes.
But yes, that you. That the thumb sinks. Yeah. Try that with the thumb. Yes. So when you play, not just that you play, but dee da dee da dee da dee da dee da da, and there's another cadence. Yes. So let me have it once more. That was very nice. But before you do that, let me have this run here. Go ahead. One, two. Soft. No, I want you to play soft. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. No. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2.
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 4. That's right. So you come out. Ah, that's what it is. Then we feel rhythmically right. Before, it was always one note seemed to be missing. There was nothing missing, but the rhythm was right, not right. So let me have once more from sound piano, sound piano. Piano. Still piano. Mezzo piano. Mezzo forte. One, two, three, four. No, do you want to see four? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. So
okay,
do you understand?
Try it again.
Yeah, do it, try it again. But doesn't it feel good? Because when the rhythm is good, we feel good. Do that once more. To really learn, to really study, is a painful process. Because you are made aware of what you don't. And you run up against the material which forces the most out of you, and you are not sure, will I measure up or not? And so you try again and again. But then the elevation that you feel, the happiness when you do measure up, is something very special. What Chopin wanted you to do is that you feel the F differently. The first time is... The second time is... So all of a sudden that F, instead of being tam, pa-da, ti-da-da-da-dam, pa-da, is emoting, yes? That you are the best. No, you're the best. You are the best, yes? Okay, so let me have that once more, the second one. Not fast. What I mean, fast is, let me show you. Fast is when you do this. That's fast. The left hand. The left hand is not fast.